It's spirit time on Kanichi's chill channel about One Piece, and today I want to talk about Tama, or if you want, O-Tama. So what do you think about her? Tama is the first person who Luffy met when he arrived at Wano, so she's bound to be important. She already has this incredible, overpowered ability that is bound to be useful when fighting beast pirates. But we don't really know much about Tama. What are her roots in Wano? What is her backstory? Who are her parents? The only connections we know about are Hitetsu, who is taking care of her, and now we know that Hitetsu is a blacksmith. And it doesn't look like they're relatives, like Hitetsu is her father or something. No, it just looks like he is taking care of this little child that has maybe no relation to him at all. And we know that she made friends with Ace, who is now unfortunately dead, and now it is up to Luffy to fulfill the promise Ace made to Otama. So yes, it is interesting, but it would be even more interesting if she had some connections to a person who is very important to Wano itself. Basically, my theory is that she's a granddaughter of Grandpa Hyou. Damn, even his name is Grandpa Hyou. He's somebody's grandpa. And there are a few reasons why I think they are related. But, you know, I have to say, it is only my speculation. It is only my theory. There are no definite facts that, yeah, for sure, they are relatives. So first of all, when we met Tama, I remember in translator's notes it was said that she's kind of talking like a yakuza. And also she's calling Luffy Aniki, which is also like a yakuza thing to do. So since she talks like a yakuza, we can presume that she has connections to some of the yakuza. And it wouldn't be that interesting if it was some other yakuza boss, because they are more of a minor characters, but Grandpa Hyou is a pretty important character. He's like a teacher of Luffy for now, and he's the most important yakuza in Wano. He was the boss of the Flower Capital. And the way we talk is really influenced by our upbringing. Another thing that can be passed to a child is the way we see world, our values. And this is another thing that is very similar with Tama and with her, their sense of honor. They're really serious about honor. Her states that he's really impressed that there are still some youngsters who have this strong sense of honor, like Luffy. And Tama, she thinks it dishonorable that her stomach rumbles, and that's why she drank that poisonous water, because she didn't want to bring dishonor on herself. It even in that moment where Hitetsu is saying like, Luffy, well, he didn't know his name yet, like, dude, why did you eat her rice? It was the rice for her birthday. And she's like crying, saying, please don't bring dishonor on me. I gave him that tries because he saved my life. So she has really strong beliefs about what honor is, and she's really trying to follow it. Granted, their hair color is not the same, but it is pretty close. So as we know, Hyou, we didn't see him in the anime yet, but on the colored pages of manga cover, I think we saw that his hair is blue, and Otama, we saw her red in the anime, and her hair is dark violet. It is likely that her parents maybe died from hunger during Orochi's reign, but she couldn't go to her granddad because her granddad was in prison. He couldn't look after her. So either somehow Grandpa Hyou asked Hitetsu to take care of his granddaughter, or maybe it wasn't possible and Hitetsu was just a friend of the family and he took her in as a child of his old friend. Maybe Hitetsu doesn't even know that she's a granddaughter of Grandpa Hyou. Maybe it just so happened that he took her in because she was here waiting for Ace, and that's just how it went, and he has no idea either. It is only my speculation and there is no definite proof, but I really like this theory. What do you think about it? Share your thoughts in the comments down below. See ya!